Sarah J.
Foodie extraordinaire, Michael Hummel. I want to hear everything because I know we had to kind of get rid of 2020's restaurant week.
Yes.
So this one's coming back bigger and better, right?
Yeah, here's definitely hoping so. So far, I think we're already up to like roughly 40 restaurants.
Yum.
The last year that we got to do it was 2019. And I want to say we had like 25-ish roughly. So
you know,
we're pushing double that amount already. So we're pretty excited about that. Obviously, restaurants need our help more than ever right now. So we're fired up about it.
Now, I see a lot of stuff is going on the social media. So I would love for you to tell everybody where they need to follow because you're giving stuff away.
We are giving stuff away. Pretty much every week until the event, we're going to be giving out some gift cards. Check us out on Facebook and Instagram, Yakima Valley Restaurant Week. We run the exact same promotions with the exact same time frames and all of that on both platforms. And I believe the one we've got going on right now, it should be wrapping up in either today or tomorrow, is highlighting women restaurant owners, which is just so cool because we were shocked to learn I think it was only 7% of restaurants in America are owned by women. And
what?
As we all know, yeah, women are like the best cooks ever. So it should be a higher number.
It should be. So hopefully this inspires some more female chefs to get it going. They're
absolutely.
Like, I don't have time. I'm cooking for everybody else. What you want?
Absolutely.
Now, can restaurants still get their hat in the ring if they want to be a part of this?
They absolutely can. Reach out to us via those social media platforms, or you can go to yakimarestaurantweek.com, ping us there. We are doing a sign-up link this year, so if somebody wants to just reach out to us, all we will do is send you back a link, and you fill it out. It makes it super easy, and then it gives us all of the data in like an internal database, basically. So we can keep it nice and sorted, and as menus come in, it attaches to where they belong and all that good stuff, and then we can promote for everybody. So super easy. It takes like 5 minutes to complete the link to get your info in, and just like that, you're ready to roll and participate.
I love this. So when do we have to like mark our calendars for?
We are doing 2 weeks this year, which is so exciting because, again, restaurants need our help more than ever. I mean, no industry got hit worse by the pandemic than the food and restaurant industry, right?
Yes.
So this year it is Yakima Valley Restaurant Weeks, plural. We are doing it from April the 3rd to April 17th. It's a two-week event this year to try and get out and support those guys the best that we possibly can. We are starting to put out some menus and things. I believe those are scheduled to start going out in like 2 days. So keep an eye out for them because they're coming and we're super excited about it.
That's awesome. So being that it hasn't happened since 2019 and maybe somebody's listening for the first time, how would you describe Restaurant Weeks?
Restaurant Week is just a celebration of food in the Yakima Valley. We did not come up with the idea ourselves. It's been going on in bigger cities for probably 20 years now. And probably 4 years ago, I believe, the brothers Ullman, Matt and Michael, started it through Leadership Yakima. It was their project. And again, it's just a celebration of food, the restaurants, everything that's happening in the valley. You know, we are so well known for our hops and our agriculture and our beer and our wine and all of that. But there's a lot of really cool things happening right now with all of our restaurants. And folks just seem to be missing that boat a little bit. And so we want to highlight that and kind of bring that to the forefront. So that's really all it is. It's just a way to celebrate everything that's happening with the food culture around here. And, you know, we've got restaurants from the high-end fancy, if you're trying to get all dolled up and go out for date night, all the way down to just nice casual lunch spots. And if you're just looking for good grub on the cheap, we've got those options for you too. And it runs the gamut in between. We've got lots of good stuff for people to check out this year.
And you guys set it up in a way that it kind of has tiers for each restaurant, right?
It does. So we don't want to put too many restrictions on the restaurant. We want them to shine in their creativity. That's the whole point of being a chef, right? Is that's their artistic platform. So we encourage them to be as creative as possible. The one restriction or guideline, I guess I should say, that we do give the restaurants is we ask them to offer their menu items for the week or 2 weeks in this case, $15, $25, or $35. And they have the complete freedom within those parameters to do what they want. They might just offer you one restaurant week special at the $25 price point, or they might pick all three price points and do something different. We see a lot of restaurants maybe highlight that $15 price point for the lunch crowd, and then maybe it's a $25 or a $35 price point for the dinner crowd. They're doing something a little bit nicer, a little bit more complete meal in that regard. So that's really all that we ask them to stay within, and then from there, complete freedom for them, and we really encourage them to do something that's not on their normal menu. We want them to get creative. Bring some old recipe from, you know, from your parents or grandma or something like that, or maybe they've been kicking around ideas in the kitchen and looking for the right platform to showcase showcase it and give it a try and see if it works and add it to the menu full time. Well, Restaurant Week's the perfect opportunity to do that and get folks trying something new.
Yeah, and this would be a good time, too, for people to test out stuff they haven't done and then write reviews.
Yes, absolutely. 100% get out and try things that you haven't tried before, and then obviously write reviews. And you kind of see that going on right now with the Food Mob group through social media, and they're just doing some awesome things supporting the restaurants here in town, and I love to see that.
Amen.
And yeah, they push really hard for making sure that you're getting good reviews on there, because, you know, small businesses need that in general, and then certainly, again, to the restaurants and the bars and everybody else that got hit so hard with the pandemic. They need our love and our support right now more than ever.
Definitely. We got to show it in any way that we can. So if you're feeling like you're broke as a joke, a review is a great way to support without, you know, well, we're all about to be a little bit richer.
You're absolutely right. Yeah, touche, right? We all got a check coming somewhere.
Now, I call you a master foodie, and I know you and your family are always out and about posting about local restaurants. What are some restaurants that are added onto this list this year that you're super excited about?
You know what? There's a couple that make me really, really excited. I don't know if people know this, but out in Cowichi Creek Brewing, what Derek Norberg, the owner out there, has done from a food standpoint, I mean, his beer is already awesome. But when the pandemic hit, he did such a phenomenal job at reacting, because when those first restrictions came out, if you don't have food, you can't reopen. But the folks that could kind of partially open when everybody was trying to figure that out. So while a lot of folks just kind of shut down and were waiting it out, Derek said, well, I'm going to start offering a food program. So he partners with a company and starts doing some higher end sausages and hot dogs and things like that. And he literally just pulled out a grill, started serving some things that way. And it was really good. And the response is great. And he made some great food. And then he just kind of kept progressing. And now the guy has built out a whole kitchen, and he is cranking out burgers that, I tell you, they might be the best burger in town. They're just phenomenal. He does a chuck and a brisket combination. His buns are so soft. Their fries are hand cut, double fried properly and crispy. There's a prime rib sandwich out there. I've been all about Cowichi Creek lately. I just love what he's got going on. A couple of other little ones for you, though, that might surprise you. Willie D's out in Wiley City has joined on this year. They do great bar food with great burgers and sandwiches, stuff like that. And then we're getting some folks involved in the Lower Valley this year, which I absolutely love. And there's a little establishment down in Grandview called Javi's Chicken and Churros. And if you have not checked that out before, it is worth the drive. Get down there and eat that food, because it is to die for. It is that good.
Ah, what a foodie description you just gave. How fun, too, Yakima Valley, because we truly are. I mean, we are just an eclectic group of all these tiny little cities, and we are traveling around all the time. So I love that these extra restaurants are getting involved.
Yeah, it's super cool to see it expand down into the Lower Valley. We've got a couple others down there, and then, you know, it's out into Sela a bit, and we really want to hit the Yakima Valley the best that we possibly can. And, you know, again, good food comes in all forms. It can be a high-end, fancy, white linen, you know, dress-up type meal, or it can be, personally for me, food always tastes better when you're standing up. I don't know why, but when you buy it at a little stand or on a street or something like that, and you're standing there and eating it with a couple of friends, for some reason, that just always seems to taste better to me, and I love those kind of places. And we've got some great spots like that. We've got a couple of taco trucks involved. So, yeah, I mean, we've really got something for everybody this year, and super, super excited to showcase it.
It's going to hit right for sure.
Yeah, right when the weather's changing, right? Starting to get nice out, and the event's a little bit later this year. We typically try and do it in March, but just kind of talking with the restaurant owners and things with some of the restrictions, the consensus was let's push it back a little bit in hopes that we're a little bit more open, which we are now getting the good news that we are, and that's all going to open to 50% just in time for the event. I think it's working out great, and hopefully folks will get out and participate and support our restaurants.
What's the cutoff for the restaurants to get their stuff submitted?
It's vague.
Okay. Just do it before it's go time.
It's like anything else where, like, you tell them that the cutoff date is one date, knowing that it's probably not going to be there by that time.
That's fair.
And I get it. Chefs work their tails off.
Right.
Folks in the restaurant industry, those folks work harder than anybody. So we certainly get it. But the drop dead deadline that we are asking for is coming up, be like the 19th, 20th.
Okay.
And that gives us enough time to get your information, because by that point, we have most of the social media scheduled. You know, things are ready to go. And, like, yes, we can throw some stuff in last minute. But, you know, all the folks, you know this, there, all the folks that put on this event, we all have pretty demanding day jobs as it is. And
yes,
we do this stuff in the nights and the weekends and things. So out of courtesy to our time as well, we kind of ask that folks, please don't push it to the very last minute, because we can't promise you that we have the time to get you promoted, get you out there if you're coming in at the last second.
Right. And behind the scenes, everybody's just doing it. They just love food, and they want everyone to know about the food. This is not, you're not getting paid to do this.
No, we are definitely not getting paid to do this. It's 100% put on by sponsorship money. My agency, shameless plug, Hummel Agency, the presenting sponsor.
Yay!
But then we've got some other sponsors through town. But yeah, it's a handful of sponsors, and that's where 100% of the funds come from. There's no cost to the restaurants to participate. And yeah, it's a group of people trying to do something cool for Yakima. We all really love food and believe that food brings people together, and we love this community, so it's a way to give back and do something cool once a year.
Ugh, sure does. Cannot wait.
Start stashing a couple bucks away. You've got a good 3 weeks to save up again. Definitely keep an eye on social media. That's where we do the majority of our communication. Our website is great and slick, but until we get that information from restaurants in regards to menus and things, we can't really fully update it. So as it comes in, we kind of update on the fly. So that information is there, but social media is absolutely the best way to go. So keep an eye on our social media posts. Start following those pages so you can be aware of when we run promotions. And we're giving out $100 gift cards, $50 gift cards. You get to pick your restaurant. We will go to that restaurant and buy that gift card specifically from them, so we know for sure the money goes to the restaurant that it should. And it's just a way to give back. And, hey, you can go out and eat during restaurant week for free, possibly.
Oh, my gosh. That if it's free, it's for me. I love that business so, so much. Michael, thank you for taking some time out to share with everybody. And from a media standpoint, definitely, the sooner you get your business in, the sooner I can talk about it. Everybody's getting free plugs on this one.
Absolutely. 100%. And thank you so much for taking the time to allow me to come on and being a supporter of the event. You have been every year, and we're grateful for that. So thank you for everything you do for us.
Right back at you.